Today, there are 2 million descendants of French-Canadian immigrants living in New England. These are our stories. Welcome to the French-Canadian Legacy Podcast.
Venez tous jeunes filles et garçons, je vais vous raconter l'histoire de notre immigration ici au USA, de grands aventuriers des pays étrangers.
Bonjour everyone, this is Melody with French-Canadian News here on the podcast. We'll start with an article titled COVID-19, an association for helping French seniors in New York. The volunteer group calls French senior citizens so they can have someone to talk to if they are alone. They also contact local groups to assist them further if needed. The volunteer group wants to create a sense of community for these seniors so they don't feel so alone during these times. Next up, stay entertained with this week's French programs on TV5 Monde USA. From a classic 1961 French drama to a documentary featuring the Palace of Versailles' hidden construction and more, check out the article for the full list. For a history lesson about Quebec, check out this online series, Histoire des Femmes au Québec, The History of Women in Quebec. You can learn about women's history in Quebec from 1600 to the present day. The videos are in French, but some of them do offer English subtitles. Even though I'm still working on my French, I translated what I could and I did enjoy a few of the videos with the English subtitles on. So maybe this could also be a great way to continue learning French. To learn about French cooking while you're stuck indoors, check out an interview with Melissa Clark, author of the cookbook Dinner in French. Clark states that France is where I learned how to cook and offers advice for quick and authentic French cooking. From the Bangor Daily News, we have a story from Juliana LaRue titled Mémé's Catalpa Trees. In this article, LaRue talks about her family's tradition of growing catalpa trees. She says, "We have named them Mémé's Catalpas because they have family roots. Their roots are real, roots, and generational." Read on to learn more about this Franco-American family's tradition. We have an article by David Vermette titled, "Why Do I Tell the Franco-American Story?" This story was originally posted on the French-Canadian Legacy Podcast blog, which features other writers, so check out the blog for more. Vermette tells us how certain events in his life brought him into his Franco-American heritage and highlights his progression of learning the importance of the Franco-American story. Go check it out and maybe you will find inspiration in telling your own story. On Query the Past, we have Patrick O'Carr with two blog posts titled Franco-American History in 10 Documents. There is Part 1 and Part 2. LaCroix has provided us with iconic Franco-American documents and moments in history. He says it is hoped that these texts will encourage readers to explore new dimensions of French-Canadians' North American journey. So for more reading material, you've got two parts to check out. Next up, we have exciting news. The Rhode Island Historical Preservation and Heritage Commission has announced that the National Park Service has added the former First Universalist Church, now the American French Genealogical Society's Franco-American Heritage Center, to the National Register of Historic Places. You can read more about the building in the article provided by the American French Genealogical Society. Last time I had virtual tours of Paris and other cities in France. Now you can take a virtual tour of Lewiston, Maine and learn about its rich Franco-American history. However, this virtual tour has a twist. Each tour ends with a pop quiz. So you must pass the quiz to move on to the next tour, so pay close attention. For podcasts, check out the North American Francophone Podcast's latest episode. Host Claire Marie Brisson interviews Janie Moyen, a Francophone from Saskatchewan advocating as a youth voice for her community. Now on to events. On June 10th at 12 p.m., join musician Robert Sylvain for the Tiny Screen Concert by Maine Public. Sylvain plays the music of the Acadians, along with blending music from other French cultures. The event will be hosted through Zoom. On June 11th, from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m., join the University of Maine in their virtual event, Around the Kitchen Table with Susan Palin and Maureen Perry, Family Heirlooms, What Do We Do With Them? This event will be hosted through Zoom. Alliance Francois is offering online French classes throughout June on various dates, so check out the post to find a class that works with your schedule. These are classes that require payment for access, but there are a variety available, so check them out and see if there's one for you. That's all I've got for you this time. Let's enjoy the sun as summer begins and continue to discover new activities. Thanks for listening.
Now, this week's guest of the podcast is Anne Conway, who's the director of the Museum of Work and Culture, and that is in Woonsocket, Rhode Island. Now, it's actually kind of fun. We get the question a lot as to whether or not that we've ever heard of or been to the French Franco-American Museum that they have in Woonsocket, and we absolutely have. It's an amazing, amazing place. We can't, obviously, it's not open now. We are super excited for it to hopefully open up again in the very near future. And when it does, we absolutely recommend everybody get down there. I mean, it's our museum. It's a museum that tells our story, which I think is super, super neat. So it was very, very exciting to be able to talk to Anne, the director of that museum. She was actually also a 2017 inductee to the American French Genealogical Society's Franco-American Hall of Fame. So really, really interesting conversation. Awesome person. She does much more than even just run this museum. I don't know where she finds the hours of the day, but she does a lot of amazing things. So it was really cool to be able to connect with her. And as for the bonus clip, you'll note that Anne is not from New England. She actually came down from Quebec. So we talk a little bit about what some of her impressions were of us here in New England when she moved down.
Okay, before we go, that was fun. Thank you. Before we go, just give you a heads up. Well, the way we do our podcast is every other week we have a completely full episode. That's where we'll air this interview. In the off weeks in between, we air kind of like a preview of the upcoming episode. So people, mm-hmm. if they want, can look into the topic that we're going to be discussing the following week. And we always throw in at the end a kind of a bonus question that involves something that we did not talk about at all during the interview.
Okay.
Kind of is our fun preview. And my bonus question for you, and I'm kind of curious, obviously you're not from New England originally, being from Quebec, Quebec City, which is an awesome town. I love that place. I kind of want to move there. I might have to get your help in making that happen. But I'm curious, what surprised you the most being from Quebec? And what do you think would surprise our listeners? Because we do have listeners in Quebec. What do you think would surprise them if they were to come down and visit New England?
How very much alike we are.
That's awesome.
I think that, I find that I it was very easy for me to talk to people who could, you know, relate to my culture, my, my traditions, and how willing people are to share their culture too, if they are from other, you know, ethnic backgrounds. So I think people are great around here.
That's awesome. Thank you so much, Anne. Appreciate it.
Okay, you're very welcome.
Now our fathers look at us and sigh with despair to think that everything they love we simply do not share. But the spirit never dies, so our culture will survive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive.
Special thanks to Josie Vachon for providing the music. You can find more about her at josievachon.com. This podcast was produced and edited by Mike Campbell. If you have any questions or comments, please email us at fclpodcast@gmail.com. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at fclpodcast for more information about the topics discussed. If you enjoyed the show, please subscribe and leave us a review on iTunes or wherever you listen to this episode.